What's going on? Brian Tong here with all your Googleicious. It's everything Google that we can pack inside of a show. Lots of news around the latest smartphones, and the biggest buzz is around the Samsung Galaxy Note 5 this week after OnLeaks revealed a video with a rendering of the device from his Foxconn sources. Now, the Note 5 will still have a spot for its signature stylus, but it will take cues from the S6 with curved glass panes on the front and rear with a metal frame between them. The camera lens will also still be protruding from the body. Now, we're still expecting an announcement sometime in July. OnLeaks also shared an image of the CAD design for the Galaxy S6 Edge Plus with its 5.5-inch screen design that aligns with the leaked images we've seen of the purported device over the past month or so. And something is finally being done about bloatware on your phone. Samsung and Oppo are facing lawsuits by the Shanghai Consumer Rights Protection Commission over their use of pre-installed apps. Now, in their study of over 20 phones, these preloaded apps were not only found, but also unremovable. You know what I'm talking about. Now, Samsung's biggest offender, the Note 3, with 44 pre-installed apps out of the box, and Oppo's Find 7a phone had 71. We'll see how this all shakes out, but it could be a starting point to minimize bloatware from every manufacturer, which is a good thing. And in other phone news, here's to keeping things ambiguous, but less ambiguous with the OnePlus 2 phone. CEO Peter Lau says the phone will cost less than $450, after the company earlier said it would cost more than $322. So somewhere in between for the base model. Thanks, guys. This marketing strategy really just has to be a joke, right? Also, Evleaks has released an image of BlackBerry's latest Android-based slider phone, codenamed Venice, that was reported by Reuters last month. The assumption is this phone, which looks pretty sleek, will slide up to reveal its keyboard, and if so, it's still really slim when you look at the USB port and headphone jack on the bottom of this image. And there's a new kid on the block. Take a look at the Turing phone, built from what they call a revolutionary liquid metal called liquid morphium. This phone is touted as being stronger than titanium and steel. It also features end-to-end mobile authentication to keep your information and communications locked away from third parties with a 5.5-inch 1920 by 1080 display, 3 gigs of RAM, and a 2.5 gigahertz quad-core Snapdragon 801 processor. Now, the company says it will be available to pre-order on July the 31st. Also, a Google device recently passed through the FCC, codenamed GG1, and the interwebs instantly thought it was Google Glass, but according to reports, it's believed that this version is being referred to as the Enterprise Edition or Google Glass EE. If you remember, Google Glass Explorer Edition was referred to as XE. There are several Glass for Work startups where the new hardware is being tested for applications, including its video streaming capabilities, but it's specifically targeting the workplace right now. Internal images for the filing are expected to be available to the public on December 28th of this year, so we should be able to get a good glimpse probably before that time for Google's latest Glass iteration. And finally, a Wall Street Journal report says Google is testing out their own carpooling service for commuters in Israel. It's being offered through the navigation app Waze and another one called Ride With. It pairs commuters looking for a ride to work or back home from Ride with Waze users going in the same direction. Google says it's a test pilot that's not competing with Uber, but really a platform they're building to enable local drivers to help during busy commute hours. And who knows, it might be an easy Waze to find love. All right, that's gonna do it for this week's show. You can always email us at googleicious@cnet.com or tweet me at Brian Tong. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you all next time for some more of that Googleicious. Googleicious.